Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, I'm going to show you how the list section works and how to set it up. The purpose of this section is really to have a single place to manage all of the lists which you might be referencing in multiple templates. So for things like cost codes, for plant, lists of people or subcontractors, you can set up multiple lists with items within each, and then you can reference those from inside of your templates. So there's really two reasons why you'd want to set this up. The first is if you've got multiple templates or multiple fields inside of those templates, you might want to reference, you know, the same list instead of having to manually type a list every time or manually enter the information each time. So it's quicker to enter the information. So that's the first reason. The second is so that you can apply filters inside of your analytics section. So I'll get to that in a minute, but basically in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to set it up, how to add a list to a template, and then I'll show you some examples of how that can be used. So the first thing to note is that I have set up a project right here. So I'm looking at the project level. So you'll notice that if I go to the team, we've got home, analytics, photos, templates, but we don't have a list section. That's all managed at the project level because it's, you know, the list that you set up will be referenceable across every team within your project. The list is unique to the project. So if I click on the project, you'll see that we've got home, we've got lists. So this is the section to set it up. I've already gone ahead and set up a cost codes list, but I'm going to set up a list for subcontractors as well. So I'm going to click this green button up here. Subcontractors, and I'm going to add a couple of just dummy examples here. Just give me a second. I'm just making this up, of course. So we've got a couple of options here, and now we want to reference that inside of one of our templates, or we might want to set it up in multiple templates, you know. We've got three templates set up here. You know, you might want to have a dropdown for your subcontractor inside of your site diary. You might also want to have it if you're tracking delays or change events or on variations. You might want to have a dropdown for what subby it's related to. So the reason that you'd set up the list is so that, you know, if you need to use the same list across multiple templates, you can. And if you make a change, then it will automatically update inside of each of these. But anyway, if I click on the template, I've created just one record so far, and you'll see that so far, this information, this subcontractor information, and this cost code information has been typed in manually. So I can, you know, I can come in and change this to whatever I want. But the problem with that is that you end up with, you know, spelling mistakes or errors in your data, which makes it harder to find later on. So, and you'll see that when I go and add a new diary, you'll see that it's all text at the moment. So if I went, you know, BBA engineering as an example, instead of BBB, I could easily make that mistake. So basically what we're going to be doing is setting it up so that that'll get recorded as a drop-down list. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Edit Template. I'm going to scroll down and find that table. So the labor table that we were looking at just a minute ago. We've got a text field set up at the moment for this subcontractor, but I'm going to change that now. I'm going to select the list option, and then I'm going to refer to the list which we created just before called subcontractors. And I'm going to do the same thing for that cost codes list, which I'd previously already set up as well. So now for each of these columns inside of this labor table, we're going to be referring to some drop-down lists. So I'm going to go ahead and click save. And now you'll notice that if I go and add a new diary, scroll down to the labor table, I can no longer type this information in. I can only choose from this predetermined list of options. So I can click, you know, AAA, and I can choose from those cost codes which we'd set up just before, and I can enter these in as required. So all of this information is standardized when I go and fill out my forms now. So in the analytics section, if I'm pulling from a site diary template from the labor table and the hours column, and I'm pulling all of my data and plotting that over time, what I can do is, because I've got some drop-down lists which are standardized set up, I can start to filter by those. So I can go click here, add filter, and then I can filter by, in this example, by subcontractor. So I can now filter by, I don't know, XYZ contracting, and it pulls up specifically the data related to XYZ contracting. And the beauty of the list is that if I had a list set up for subcontractor, for cost code, for work area, for work activity, those are the parameters by which I can then filter through all of my data, which I've been collecting through all of my entries. So if I just show you quickly in here with our site diary, with all of these records coming in, because I've got a standardized list inside of this template here, which I've been referencing, we can start to filter by all of these entries here. So that pretty much wraps it up for the list section. If you've got any questions, the best place to start is always our Help Center. So we've written a whole bunch of articles explaining how all of this works in further detail. But if you can't find what you're looking for, feel free to send us a message via the live chat. Thanks for watching.